Hey guys, it's Mike Thurston here and we're on day 4. So I hope you've all recovered from our back session yesterday. Today we're gonna do arms, biceps, triceps. Today I'm combining both bicep, tricep. You know, it's not the only way to train them. Sometimes you can train biceps with another body part. Today we're just focusing on biceps, triceps, and we're gonna be doing high volume. So we're not necessarily gonna be lifting as heavy as we possibly can. What we're gonna do is we're gonna do supersets. So we're gonna do a bicep, tricep, tricep, bicep, tricep, so on. And I'm gonna do 3 sets of each. First exercise, probably one of the most challenging ones I've found, is we're gonna do pull-up supinated grip, and we're gonna superset that with a incline curl. So the bench is gonna be about 45 degrees, you're gonna be leaning back and doing it with dumbbells. So what you wanna focus on when you're doing the pull-ups is to try and place the tension as much as possible on your biceps. So you can use the pull-up either to focus on your lats or biceps. In this case, it's gonna be biceps. So as we pull ourselves up to the top of the bar, you wanna almost curl yourself into the bar itself and contract your biceps as hard as you can. If you can't do more than 6 or 7, what I want you to do is just stand up or jump up and slowly take the negative for about 4 to 5 seconds until you fully lock out and then go back up to the top. So once you've done, I did 10 reps of that, I'm gonna go on to the incline dumbbell curl and gonna go for a weight which you can at least get 10 reps out on. You're gonna lock out at the bottom, curl all the way to the top, squeeze your biceps as hard as you can, slowly lower the weight back down, lock out again, and repeat. You don't need to go too heavy with this, especially as it's a superset. When you're doing the second exercise, you're gonna be fatigued. And when you come to do the second and third set, you're gonna be even more fatigued. So don't worry if you do have to lower the weight on the second and third set. Next superset we did was triceps, so we're giving the biceps a bit of a rest. With the first exercise, I'm gonna do an overhead EZ extension. So what I'm actually doing, I'm gonna put the bench quite steep, about 60, 70 degrees. I'm gonna lean back on it. I'm gonna grab the EZ bar. I'm gonna keep my elbows right above my head, keep them fixed, and I'm gonna extend the EZ bar right above my head. I'm gonna lower it all the way back down and lengthen the tricep as much as possible. So I'm gonna go for 10 reps on that, and then I'm gonna move on to close grip barbell press. So with this one, I'm keeping my elbows tucked in as much as possible so they're almost dragging past my torso as I bring that weight down. You can do it on a bench if you want to, but I did it lying down. So the reason why I do it flat is because as my elbows touch the ground, that's as far down as I want to go. If I go any lower, I'm going to start to stretch my pectoral muscles, in which case, as I press back up, I'm actually going to engage some of my chest before I start to press with my triceps. Third exercise, back to biceps. This one, we're gonna use the EZ bar, and we're gonna do what's called a reverse curl. And then we're gonna superset that with a dumbbell curl, but we're gonna be leaning forward on a bench. It's about 45 degrees, so we're manipulating the strength curve a little bit there. So to start off with the reverse grip, EZ curl, you're only bringing the EZ bar up halfway. We're trying to hit a different part of the bicep head when we do this. And we're gonna slowly lower it back down to the bottom, lock out, bring back up to the top and squeeze. So it's important you're not just trying to rush through these reps, you're really trying to think about what you're doing, and as you bring the EZ bar up, contract your biceps. You are gonna get quite a bit of forearm work on this one as well, which is quite beneficial. So if you've done 10 of them, I'm gonna move on to the lying down, face down on the bench about 45 degrees. I'm just gonna do standard dumbbell curls, squeezing for 1 second at the top of each rep. Next exercise, we are gonna do dips, supersetted with tricep cable extension. So with the dips, I'm gonna make it a little bit more challenging and I'm gonna put a dumbbell in between my knees. So it basically makes my overall weight a little bit heavier. So I'd be doing I'd be adding 15 kilograms to my overall weight. So we're going for about 10 reps on that, 8 to 10, and then move on to the tricep extensions. Now when I'm doing this with the rope, I'm using two ropes because two ropes allows me to completely lock my arms up and get maximum range of motion, so I can actually shorten my tricep as much as possible whilst then returning to the starting position and lengthening the tricep. The problem when you do it with one rope is that as you pull it down, your hands are kind of stuck at your hips. You cannot pull that rope any further apart. Your triceps aren't fully contracted. When doing dips, if you're trying to place attention on your triceps, you want to keep your torso a little bit more upright. And I always tell my clients, keep your head up and look straight in front of you. Next exercise we did was back to biceps, another superset. Lying down on the bench, we're doing a cable curl towards forehead, supersetting that with a standing rope curl. So with the cable curl, this one's is quite a unique movement because you're almost pulling the weight towards your forehead, something you can't replicate if you're standing upright. So I put a bench underneath a cable attachment with you see the flat or EZ sort of bar shape. And what I do is actually put my head back a little bit further to increase the range of motion so that I can really shorten the bicep as much as possible. So by doing this, I'm changing the angle of the resistance. The other one was a standing rope curl. So again, I'm changing the grip. I'm using a neutral grip and the force is acting not directly below me, but from behind me. So again, I'm going to be locking out of the bottom, bringing the ropes up, not all the way to the top, because when the cable's in line with your forearm, the tension kind of ceases to exist. You want the cable just to be pointing or pulling down away from your forearm. So I don't go all the way up to the top. I'll go about 3/4 of the way up, squeeze the contraction, and then go back down to the bottom. Next one, final one, was on triceps. We are going to do an overhead extension. We're going to use the bench, we're going to put the angle slightly lower, and this time we're going to put a cable attachment higher, so the force is going to be acting from more of a 45 degree angle. So I'm going to use two ropes, so again to maximize the range of motion. I'm going to go for about 10 to 12 reps on this one, and then I'm going to go on to a standing cable press down. So I'm going to push the cables down all the way, lock out, squeeze my triceps, and then bring it back up to the top. So the key thing with this one is to keep your shoulders back and pop your chest out a little bit. And generally when it comes to all bicep and tricep movements, your body shouldn't be moving backwards and forward. You shouldn't be creating momentum. You want everything to be fixed, and the only movement that should be occurring is at the elbow joint. So guys, I hope you enjoyed my high volume arm training session. We've got one more workout left, and that's going to be core, followed by some high intensity interval training. So tune in tomorrow, I hope you enjoy.